have been taken place in our society, that Jesus, please change this society and make this society more beautiful. We pray for our church, that the church should be more strong. Our preacher, our evangelist, our apostles, whatever kind of elders, deacons, we pray for this, and that there should be a true gospel from their lips, and they pray the true God, and they taken this holy word as this given to me and Sister Robeline and many your other servants. They take this true gospel and true message of our God to other people. They do not make confuse any other people. Hallelujah. They don't confuse any other. I do not like those people who confuse by their preaching. There is one straight Jesus Christ, and is for everyone. He's for everyone. He's for same for Pastor Kamran, same for evangelist, and same for everybody. And this is a gospel, a true gospel, who don't confuse any human being, who don't confuse any man and any woman and any child. This is the way of salvation. This is the path to the salvation. We must follow this path and take our salvation and take by freely. No penny given to. And you take this gospel freely from our Jesus Christ, this holy gospel. And I pray for all pastors as well who confusing the people. I pray that this Holy Spirit touch them as well, and they preach the true gospel in the mighty and the glorified name of our Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. 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 Wow. Well, thank you so much for praying for us. Everyone, this is Pastor Sadegh in Pakistan, and we're just so grateful that you came and that we were able to connect for a change with the internet connections and stuff. We were online waiting for you last night, and I was just getting ready to lay down and go to sleep, and I've had all kind of internet issues myself, and so was just getting back online, so this was just perfect timing. So how are you?
I'm fine, sister. I'm fine.
Okay. It sounds like you're eating. Are you eating?
No. I was not eating. I was drinking water.
Oh, okay. Okay.
After praying, my throat was a bit dry, so I take one.
You go on and you drink some water, because you should be dry, man, because you can preach.
Yeah.
You can pray and you can preach.
Thank you, sister. This is all your training. This is all your training.
Mine? No, ain't nobody ever heard me preach or pray like that. Not like that. Mm-mm. You play too much. Yeah.
Thank you very much for your time. Two are people who had play a very important role in my life, and my preaching is Apostle Anderson and Sister Robeline. And I don't know where is Apostle Anderson, but you are here to help me whenever I need. And both of you have, you know, Jesus said make disciples, and this is the discipleship you use me and train me. That's so thankful to you.
Well, we bless the Lord, and all wisdom comes from above, not from me. So we thank God. I thank God that His will is going forth, because it's His will that none should perish. Amen. And He said that my people perish for lack of knowledge, and so we just thank the Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit leads, guides, and directs us into all truth. And so I'm just very, very grateful, and I'm very, very thankful. I'm just like, I'm high-fiving God like all day long. I'm like, yeah, God, man, yeah, you know it, yeah. God, you are good. Heck, you know what, just I'm giving God a hand. You know, I'm just so very, very grateful for for Him even letting my eyes see the things that I'm seeing. Yes. Yeah. 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 So we got to get you to come over. We have to get you to come over to America and get you working over so you can give a sermon over here in America. Come and visit. Come visit us over here. Yeah. We'll send you a plane ticket.
Mm-hmm. You have to sponsor me.
Well, okay. Well, we'll see. You know, I got that helicopter now.
Yeah. You can pray for me. Mm-hmm. I have a plan to be, you know, preaching this year internationally. You can pray for me that may the God given us resources. So I can fly to a few countries to preach the gospel.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah already. My goodness. Oh, my goodness.
I put this plan in front of Jesus Christ, and you're going to be praying with me for this plan, that may Jesus take me. I have a plan to this year. I have to be preach this gospel to internationally. This is my plan, and I will, you know, I have to do this now. That was the right time.
Hallelujah. That's all I got to say is hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Wow. Ooh, I want to go. I'm so excited for you. Thank you, Jesus. Look at that. I'm about to praise God until I stop praising. Hallelujah. Wow. Ooh, I'm so excited. My goodness. God bless you so much, and I praise God for your obedience, and I'm just asking God for a very, very special blessing on you and on your life because of the sacrifice. It's a great sacrifice, and it's a great cost that I, as a fellow servant, I know what it takes to serve God wholeheartedly. And so just God bless you. Oh, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. So what else have you been up to?
I was doing a bit ministry, a smaller ministry in Pakistan. Not bigger, very smaller ministry. Mm-hmm. And I've been away from church. It's due to I have been over here in Lahore, and now I have been able to establish over here the church now. That was when my struggle to be, you know, I was right about 9 months in Lahore. I was away from home, you know that. Mm-hmm. I was away from the church over there in Khanewal. Mm-hmm. You were there to be preached in Khanewal, but you never been able to preach over here. So now I have been attached to properly a church over here. I was preaching now in church, and hope so that that I might be able to arrange meetings as well. This taken me so long over here to establish my feet over here. It's taken so much time.
So God's gathering in Pakistan, International Church, is established in Pakistan now?
Yeah, we can say that. We do not have, you know that we have very few resources over here.
Uh-huh.
But that's why I taken this decision to be, you know, that I must come in front and start preaching internationally and take our God gathering international church to other countries and take our mission to the other people, and hope so that God will work for us and you can pray, and you are our strength, and our sister is with us. It's been a so long time we are together, and I thank for the name that you have given to me. It's a beautiful name, God Gathering International Church in Pakistan.
Mm-hmm.
So it taken so much time. It's been taken 5 years now.
Wow. 4 or 5 years. Is it 5 years? Oh my God.
Yeah, sister, it's been a long, long time. 2011 when we started it. Mm-hmm. And now it's 2014.
Mm-hmm.
So it's been 5 years. Long time. It's long time. Long time.
Man, well, you've done a lot of preaching, because you can preach.
Yeah. I've been thanks to the God as well that he given me this. I was these words. I must thank Jesus, and now I decided myself that I must, you know, take these words to the other countries. I might visit Malaysia and Singapore and Hong Kong this
Amen.
Year.
Amen.
You can pray for me. You can pray for me. I might need your help.
Listen. Okay, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. Listen. I'm going to pray, because we all need God's help. Because I can't do nothing. You can't do nothing. Anybody can't do nothing without God. With God,
yes.
With God, all things are possible. Without God, yeah. Well, good luck with that.
Yeah, we have to do this, and I put this in Jesus' hand, and I knew that this is going to be happen. That's my faith, sister. That this is going to be happen this year.
In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name, amen. Because I have to, you know. We were doing it so much time now, and hope so that God is hearing us, and our prayers are going to the in front of Jesus, and Jesus knew that how much struggle we have done all these rest of 5 years. We must so much struggle.
Mm-hmm.
We must still not have these proper facilities in church. We should not have the sitting proper chairs and all this, and I have to take in this voice, and if we able to go over there and you know, make some joint venture with others as well. Mm-hmm. I was quite open to it and hope so that this is going to be improved by Jesus God, by our heavenly God, and he's going to use me over there very powerfully, and it's up to him, sister. It's up to him. Everything is up to Jesus.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, I'm so glad to talk to you. Thank you, Jesus.
So I was backing up, and I will be. I have a problem over here that I have. Do not have the light. You know, in 5 minutes, I might. You know, light might taken away.
Well,
they provide.
Well, we can go ahead and say goodbye now, because I probably need to. We're on the radio, so I probably need to get the music back for the people.
Okay.
Yep. So
yeah.
So hopefully I'll talk to you. Well, the next time I talk to you, and it'll be good morning, good night again for us.
Yeah. Definitely. That's why I ask evangelist Bedford that I must preach the evening time. Because evening time we probably have the light, and in the morning time they do not provide us proper light. After 5 hours the light has come up, four or five hours.
Okay, so you preach in the evening time for you, and it'll be in the morning time for us, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, no, that's even better. That's even better, because you're making it a lot harder than it had to be. No, but I'm just kidding. No, that's fine. That makes it in, because in the morning we can work that right in with the programming and things that are already going on. And either myself or Evangelist Mike will broadcast you. He sent up. I've shown him how to start you up and broadcast you the same way. And so he'll start you, and then you just get on and start preaching. Okay.
Yeah, and this.
Yes.
And in this Saturday night, mm-hmm. you will be free. Evangelist will be free on Saturday.
You you'll probably be with Evangelist Mike will be running it for you, and then I will pop in when I can, because we've got some live shows going on that night on the other radio station. That's why I have him helping me.
Oh, that's wonderful. So blessing from our heavenly Jesus Christ to you, to the family.
Amen.
How's Sister Sarah doing and his little guy?
She's doing very, very fine, and the grandbaby is big, and she's getting bigger.
She's growing now. It's been a quiet while since I've not seen him. I must. You can take up to the Skype. I will see her.
Okay. Yes, I will. Okay.
I'll get to say God bless you.
All right. God bless you.
Shalom.
Shalom. Bye bye.
Bye bye.
Well, that was Pastor Sadiq. God answered my prayer, man. We lost touch, and then it was a lot of persecution and things like that. And he's, long story short, he's safe. Yes, he's safe and blessed and highly favored in the Lord. You heard? Did you heard? Yeah, well, I heard. So, I'm going to actually wrap this up and play it right back in a Gospel Music Explosion episode. I surely am. Mm-hmm. God bless you.
I am doing unto the Lord.
To the Lord.
Unto the Lord.
Give it, what we should give it to the others is the Holy Spirit, and what we pray for is for Holy Spirit, that the Holy Spirit should come upon on every.
That's sweet right there. What the world needs now, I gotta hear that, is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little love. I'm going to play that. Oh. What the world needs now is love. No, not just for some. Oh, here we go.
Blog Talk Radio.
It's time for an audio book reading of our featured book, which is titled House Jacked, How People Steal Homes. We'll take one section of the book and read it audibly every Sunday evening. House Jacked, defined: the seizure or attempted seizure of privately owned real estate by any hostile parties, known or unknown, that are interested in stealing your dwelling or stealing any cash value distinction, including equity, of your property by legal or illegal methods. This concludes our reading of one section of the book, House Jacked.
Yeah.
Blog Talk Radio.
It's time for an audio book reading of our featured book, which is titled House Jacked, How People Steal Homes. We'll take one section of the book and read it audibly every Sunday evening. House Jacked, defined: the seizure or attempted seizure of privately owned real estate by any hostile parties, known or unknown, that are interested in stealing your dwelling or stealing any cash value distinction, including equity, of your property by legal or illegal methods. This concludes our reading.
Wow.
Of one section of the book, House Jacked.
Okay.
See you next time.
Okay, that was short and sweet. Appreciate that. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go back here. And somebody else is doing something.
Our love does not run dry, so I wait for you.
My
love, I'm burning.
I am empty, but I know your love does not run dry.
Restore the love.
of a second chance. A second chance,
forgave me, and
like only you can.
Nobody can love me like
you love me.
I thank God for
Lord, I stand presence, wanting you and needing you.
I am here and I surrender all of me so I can see.
What will they say about me? Will the world be our number one? And I, will I fall men's hearts to you? Is it well done? Right away.
I seen paper represent my life. I'm talking, that's a fact, kid. But I'ma bring them out. I'm up to the strip. My city hard, even if cops. I dedicate myself to this. I ain't telling fables. I'm tripping, not cocky.
Should come upon everybody. Bless us and we pray in your name. Miracles for us. Jesus